Because I have issues with women, God gave me a daughter. Because he's an asshole. I don't know if he knew that about God, but he can be a bit of a malacca. Considering he's a single dad himself.
Brianna Michelle Lett.
My name is Brianna Lett, and I'm Richard's daughter.
Hi.
14 years old, she'll be 15 February 8th of this year. I was married to her mother for 7 years. The last year and a half was with Brianna. When she was born, we met somebody that we loved more than each other, and that really was the burden that didn't hold up in the relationship. The other thing was, of course, that I'm a professional artist, and I can barely take care of myself, let alone a family. And it seemed clear to me that when I left, I was going to be giving those two an opportunity for some sort of economic stability that I was going to be able to provide. And that has actually happened. When I had cancer, I was terrified to tell her, right?
He just straight out told me, and I was like, okay. And he's like, are you mad at me? And I'm like, I'm not mad at you.
Usually when people have cancer, after they recuperate, they become gentler and kinder because they believe that they should not be petty, that life, every moment of life means something. Well, Richard took the exact opposite.
Like, when I first was diagnosed that the testicular cancer, it was possible that it was just going to be surgery, that it would be as, you know, new in the whole process, that it was just going to cut off the old nut. I could claim to have had a hernia operation and just move on with it. But that turned out, as we know, not to be the case, and I was stage two, and that was going to have chemo, and it was going to be obvious that I was going to be, that I was in cancer treatment. There was no hiding this. So it became imperative that I tell Brianna. So I told her, I began with, I'm going to be fine, but, and I explained to her the whole thing, explained to her what was going to go on with chemo and how this would affect me, and she said, after she goes, wow, you're in for some intense crappiness. She just cracks me up, because she remembers all this stuff, right? She remembers, like, because I didn't teach her when we were driving to sing any of the normal kids' songs, like Rinky Dinky Doo and all that fucking conspiracy of fucking stupidity. We sang How's the Rising Sun and Piano Man and Jeremiah Was a Bullfrog and all these songs, right? Here we go. I'm Francis Ford Coppola and you're Sofia Coppola, and you've just won an Oscar. And I've just told you that you don't have to pay me the $8.3 million I owe you back. Into that lens. You ready?
Okay, yeah.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
Sure. I'd like to thank my mom and my dad.
Wait, we're...
No, Dad!
Yeah! Ow! What? Is this okay?
You're prickly.
Because I can't stay over at her building tonight because I have to do a show and Mommy won't let you. It's the lads. One, two, three. All the leaves are brown.
All the leaves are brown.
And the sky is gray.
And the sky is gray.
What did Brianna do? Save my life. Again and again, with every breath, every moment. Every breath I take is because of her.
The two closest people in his life that he trusts the most and is closest to are me and his daughter. And I know his daughter is hugely important to him. So if I'm anywhere near that, then that feels good.
My relationship with Richard was pretty much fine up until the time that I was doing a gig at this room called Dentries. He was emceeing the show, and I was like the third comedian up, and he introduced me as a guy who was wasting his time by doing comedy.
He was just getting angry. Somebody's phone rang, and he got upset at her, and he just drank too much.
I got up on the stage, and I told him to fuck off.
Richard Lett, ladies and gentlemen.
It got to the point where you'd only see Richard hanging around like Jupiter, which I think was the only room he wasn't banned from.
I'm pleased to be down here and performing at the Jupiter because it's literally the only stage in Vancouver they'll let me onto.
No one talked to him because he was just like, just like wasn't making any sense, slurring his words and stuff. And so I think it's like alcohol related, but I can't comment on why he was drinking so much.
Cheers.
Richard Legg gets corporate gigs. He's fine. Like, he's able to achieve money. He's able to do some rooms in the city and get paid.
Comedy's got to him because he's done it for years and he's done it well, so.
I'll do some stuff that make you feel bad for me and then I'll close. Woke up the other morning, read the headline, realized the world's gone to hell in a handbasket. I read the headline, Nickelback wins best album. I would have been less confused by Jesus Steals Car. Stephen Harper smokes bong with life partner. Surrey Virgin graduates from high school. It would have been less confusing to me. See you guys.
One more time for Richard, please. Let's let him hear. All right.